righteousness is like the mighty mountains. Your justice like the great heap. O Lord, you preserve both man and beast. Continue your love to those who you know, the righteousness and the upright, to the upright in heart. We shall sing the hymn 382. In 382 in English, only in English, 382.
This is a demonstration of Wirecast.
For bringing us to the beginning of Holy Week in the year 2020. Thank you, Lord Jehovah, this Monday that you, Jehovah Lord, that Jesus caused the fig tree that refused to bear fruit, and of course, in which he entered the temple and drove out those that were buying and selling. Lord, we thank you for this privilege. We thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you for your goodness. Lord, accept our thanksgiving in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As human, we confess our shortcomings. In every area we have failed and disappointed you, we ask, O God, that you merciful unto us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lord, as we gather to learn at your feet, Lord, we pray that you speak to our heart and you grant us deeper knowledge of who you are and grant us privilege to move closer to you even in our daily living, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, as you drove out those that were buying and selling the temple, we pray, Lord, this day, that even as we seek your faith, that everything that you have not planted in our lives, whatever is buying and selling, be it sickness, be it satanic activities, in our lives, Lord, we pray that you drive them out yourself, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lord, we pray this evening that you will speak to our hearts.
Amen.
Draw us closer to yourself.
Amen.
Grant us deeper revelation of who you are.
Amen.
And Lord, we pray that you increase us even in every aspect of our lives in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
every person you will use tonight, Holy Spirit divine, we pray that you grant unto them unction to function even from above in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord, at the end of our journey, Lord, we pray that we will not be guilty of your word.
Amen.
Thank you, loving Jehovah, because of answer.
Blessed
and be your holy name.
Hallelujah.
For in Jesus' mighty name, we are for prayer.
Amen.
The Lord's Prayer.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our only lesson for this service is taken from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, as recorded by St. Mark, chapter 11. Reading starts at verse 11. The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ is recorded by St. Mark, chapter 11. I'll start the reading from verse 11 to verse 19. Jesus entered Jerusalem and went to the temple. He looked around at everything. But since it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. The next day, as they were leaving Bethany, Jesus was hungry, seeing in the distance a fig tree and leaf. He went to find out if it had any fruit. When he reached it, he found nothing but leaves, because it was not the season for figs. Then he said to the tree, "May no one ever eat fruit from you again." And his disciples heard him say it. On reaching Jerusalem, Jesus entered the temple area and began driving out those who were buying and selling there. He overturned the tables of the money changers and the benches of those selling doves, and would not allow anyone to carry merchandise through the temple courts. And as he taught them, he said, "Is it not written, 'My house will be called a house of prayer for all nations'? But you have made it a den of robbers." The chief priests and the teachers of the law heard this and began looking for a way to kill him, for they feared him, because the whole crowd was amazed at his teaching. When evening came, they went out of the city. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
As we prepare our hearts and minds to listen to God's mouthpiece, we shall sing the hymn in English 379. In English, 379.
Cross the nation.
Please be seated as we pray. O Lord, as we commence this journey, especially the Holy Monday in the Passion Week, we place our hope and trust in you to wet the heat of our hearts and take away from us every act of unfruitfulness as well as uncleanliness, that we may be acceptable in your sight as we travel in the course of our pilgrimage. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
Amen.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Hallelujah.
I'd like to welcome us all to this Holy Monday of the Passion Week in the year 2020. It is my prayers that God in His mercy will grant us the opportunity to witness that of this year. May we be opportune to witness more, if Christ tarries, in the mighty name of Jesus. Beloved, today we shall consider the theme that says, a fruitless and unclean generation. A fruitless and unclean generation. While our text is taken from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark chapter 11, verse 14, it read thus, Jesus said to the tree, may no one ever eat fruit from you again. And the disciples had it. Once again, we are considering the thing that says, a fruitless and as well an unclean generation. Beloved, fruitlessness, you agree with me, is not a Christian virtue. And so it is expected and mandatory for every believer to bear fruit in season and out of season. Following the arrival of our Lord Jesus Christ in Jerusalem, He has spent the night in Bethany, the village at the foot of Mount Olives, as it is recorded in Matthew chapter 21, verse 7. And upon His return, Bartimaeus understand that He was hungry, and He noticed a fig tree afar off that had produced leaves ahead of season. The fig tree, according to its custom, is expected to bring forth fruit twice in a year, precisely in the month of June as well as in the month of September. And of course, this event occurred in the month of April. So when he came to the tree and found nothing on it but leaves, he said to that tree, may no one ever eat fruit from you again. And the disciples heard what Jesus said. What a fruitless tree, created, expected to bring forth fruit, but behold, it was fruitless and as well deceptive. In the same way, from this passage read, the journey of our Lord Jesus Christ from Bethany to Jerusalem unveiled to the Master Jesus the false transformation that had taken place in the city, especially act of unholiness, uncleanness, and ungodly activities being performed in the temple. Jesus equally observed that commercialism, act of buying and selling, is now the order of the day. And on that very day, he overturned the table of money changers, and he declared forth in Matthew chapter 21, verse 13, my temple shall be called the house of prayer and not den of robbers. Dear viewers, fellow pilgrims, have you not been claiming to be fruitful, just as we saw in the life of the crowd when they all waved palm fronds yesterday, jubilating, rejoicing, celebrating the triumphant entry of our Lord Jesus Christ to Jerusalem? Check your life very well, beloved. Secondly, we were made to understand, according to the act of our Lord Jesus Christ when He entered the temple, that no form of partnership exists between cleanliness and uncleanliness. And so He decided to correct that act as that which took place in Matthew chapter 21, verse 13.
And if we take a look at what we are being faced with in our nation, Nigeria, and the world at large, it is expected of us to live at this point in time a clean and godly life, such that we may all be delivered from our present situation in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So let us examine our lives. Let us examine our ways. Let us examine our deeds as we commemorate this Passion Week of our Lord Jesus Christ. We all claim, some of us claim to live a clean and fruitful life while we dwell in the midst of unclean and unholy generation. Such will definitely produce a fruitless being. We can no longer deceive our Maker with such lifestyle. Remember Prophet Isaiah in Isaiah chapter 6 verse 5 cried, saying, "Woe is me, for I am a man of unclean lips, for I dwell in the midst of unclean people." And so, my beloved, in the midst of this act of uncleanliness, permit me to say that a fruitless believer who stands is pitched in the midst of uncleanliness, such a fellow or such a life is subject to spiritual wretchedness and as well as stagnancy. Therefore, this Monday, as we commence this all-important week in Christendom, number one, it is expected of us all to come to the Lord Jesus, accept Him as our personal Lord and Savior. John chapter 14, verse 6. Number two, confess your sins, forsake them, and be made whole. John chapter 15, verse 3. And on the third note, it is expected of us all to remain steadfast in Christ. It is expected and as well of great advantage that we remain in Christ so that we may become fruitful in season and out of season. John chapter 15, verse 5. As we conclude today, fathers and mothers, brothers and sisters, fellow viewers across the globe, come to the Lord Jesus Christ today and He will make you whole again. He will make your life fruitful and as well impactful, so that your life will produce forth fruits in season and out of season. And as you do this, you will equally be privileged to reign with Him in that heavenly kingdom. And this will not be the last you are celebrating in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Bow your heads and let us pray. Holy and faithful Father, we bless your wonderful name for the opportunity to commemorate another period of Holy Week in the land of the living. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for drawing our hearts in order to produce forth fruits worthy of acceptance and as well to live a holy and cleanful life, which is a wonderful and a precious Christian virtue. Help our hearts, O God, so that we may return unto you with a clean life and as well a fruitful one, to the glory and to the praise of your holy name. All these and many more we have asked with faith and thanksgiving through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Worthy is the Lamb.
Hallelujah. Beloved in the household of faith, it is time to go to the Lord in prayers. I ask us to be upstanding so that we reaffirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. Together we say, I believe in God, Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, Father Almighty. From thence He shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins,
the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
May we all be seated as we pray. The collect for the Holy Monday. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that though in our weakness we fail, we may be revived through the person of your only Son and the passion of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Let us appreciate God as we give him thanks for what he has done in our lives and in the world. Let's thank him for his passion for the world. Let us thank him, for he has already redeemed us from the curse of the law, and he has brought us unto the joy of his salvation. As a way of our reflection and reaction to the sermon, the word that came from the throne of God, let us submit ourselves to the Lord and ask that he will give us the spirit of fruitfulness. And because we know that cleanliness is next to godliness, ask him to purify our hearts to become his throne. Let us pray that the Lord himself will purge our hearts, our homes, his church, and our community from every vile and from every vice, so that the whole world will become his own. Let us ask for the touch of the hand of our Lord, that those who already are afflicted by the scourge of this deadly virus may be wakened by his loving hand. Finally, let us pray that all of us may all the time experience and enjoy the joy of Eastertide.
This is a demonstration of Wirecast.
And the Passion Tide of our Lord, he has reclaimed us from destruction. He has brought us unto salvation. Tell the Lord Jesus, let every day be a day of your resurrection, that the Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead will not depart from us, but we may all the time enjoy the joy of Eastertide, even now and even till eternity. Let us now bring our personal request to the throne of grace, believing that he will answer us.
This is a demonstration of Wirecast.
Let's bring our prayers to a close with words of thanksgiving. And so shall it be in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Eternal Rock of Ages, King of Kings and Lord of Lords, we worship, Lord, and magnify your holy name. Thank you, Lord Almighty, for your ineffable love that surrounds us every day. Thank you, Lord Almighty, for your goodness, for your favor, for your mercy, and for the peace that we enjoy. Lord, we want to thank you for the power that reigns in our Lord Jesus Christ, which has quickened our mortal bodies, even to worship him with reverence and awe. Father in heaven, we thank you for bringing us into the joy of another new week, especially, Lord, as we commemorate the last week of the passion of our Lord Jesus for our souls. Father, Lord Almighty, our bleeding souls. Father, we got revived, O God, through the passion and the suffering of our God, through the person of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has come as semblance of the Father. Lord, we thank you for this day, that, Lord, even as we have heard from your holy wreath, Lord, we know how porous we are. We know, O God, how vicious we are. And we know, Lord Almighty, that we cannot help ourselves. You are our helper. So we come to you, Lord Almighty, even as we have already opened our hearts unto you, that you may step into our hearts and reign, and that you may take your place. Because, Lord Almighty, we need you, the brightness of your face and the fullness of your grace. Lord, we ask that you will grant unto us that your word, which we have heard from our outer ears today, may be inwardly grafted in our hearts. Amen. And we ask, Lord Almighty, that none of us will be a child unto perdition, Amen. But we may all the time be children, that we continue to enjoy the joy of salvation. Father, Lord Almighty, we ask that you will set your cleansing over our land, over your church and our communities, and grant that only your will shall be established. And we know that your talk for us is not of evil, but of good. And that, Lord, you have promised that goodness and mercy shall follow us. So, Lord, we decree by the counsel of your divine will that your goodness shall be established over all of us in Nigeria, in Lagos State, and throughout the entire world. That, Lord Almighty, the pang of the wicked world will not come to pass in our lives. And all the deadly virus that has been tested, O God, to ravage the world and to bring the world to a standstill because of some ill-gotten minds, Father, filthy minds, and fruitless people. We ask, O God Almighty, that, Lord, all their technical know-how shall be set to nullity. Amen. And that, Lord Almighty, it shall be void and null. Amen. So that, Lord, each one of us will see the print of your nails Amen. Upon our heart. Amen. And we will cry and say, Abba, Father, because we know you will come to our rescue. Amen. So take your place in every part of our world system.
Amen.
Let only your will be established.
Amen.
That it will bring joy and peace to every one of us.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, because you have answered our prayers.
Amen.
Lord, we cannot but remember those who are already suffering from the scourge of COVID-19, which is coronavirus. Father, you are the God of all flesh, and you sent your word and heal all our diseases. Send your word to them wherever they are, those that have been quarantined, those who are on self-isolation, those already been taken care of in hospitals and emergency centers. Father, visit them with your loving hand.
Amen.
Let your healing wings locate them.
Amen.
And grant that, Lord, they shall come out, O God, more stronger and healthier. And we pray for all of us that are still under the cover of your wings, that are not afflicted. May we never be afflicted.
Amen.
Because you have promised that you will bless our food and our water, and you will take all diseases from our land.
Amen.
Father, Lord Almighty, we pray that you Put us, Lord, and keep us in the quiver of your hand, and that no evil shall befall us. Grant that, Father, at the close of this service, when all things have ended, may we have cause to rejoice that we have you as our Father who will never fail. And grant that, Lord, there will be awesome testimonies from our lips as we know that you have answered our prayers. Thank you because you have answered our prayers. We ask that you will be with us, Lord, in the name of God the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and thus promise that where two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their request. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting. Amen.
Word is the Lamb.
Hallelujah.
We bless the name of the Lord for bringing us to this gathering this evening, the first day of the Holy Week. Monday of the Holy Week is our prayer that as we journey this week, and of course throughout this Easter season, the Lord will give us grace to see him in a new way in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We just want to encourage you to follow by the same time tomorrow by the grace of God, 6 p.m. And on Wednesday likewise, 6 p.m. And of course on Thursday and on Friday where we have the Good Friday service. God bless you as we follow our services in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Amen.
The closing hymn is in 820 in English. 820 in English, 714 in Yoruba.
Thank you.
all be seated as we pray. Let's commit our ways and our thoughts into the hands of God. God, whose word cannot be broken, with Jerusalem and the entire world we are stunned this holy week, beginning from this holy Monday through the holy Tuesday, holy Wednesday, the great holy Thursday, Monday, Thursday, Good Friday, and also the eve of Easter. Like a city overcome with sudden devastation, especially the coronavirus, COVID-19, we are swept up in the confusion and desolation, wondering what is happening. The liturgy, the scripture and song immerse us even in the river that flows to betrayal and the cross. The gospel we have tried to make manageable have even overturned our tables of control. Even the suffering of Jesus that we try to avoid has endowed us. Father, the fruitless fig tree that we are told of, O God Almighty, witness even to the fact that many people are becoming cold in their feet and in their faith. And Lord, as the fig tree withers before the majesty of one whose mission is relentlessly and uncompromisingly, Lord, we ask that you will help us in our weakness, that we may always try and always put our trust in you. Help us, O Lord, with all your church, so to invite you and to watch and pray, to behold anew the unfolding scandal and the ragged good news of salvation. Behold us with your mercy, O God, even in the agonies of this world, and when the suffering of Jesus has been completed, both then and now, grant that our joy will overflow. Amen. Let our prayers, O God, we offer unto you, both for us and for the nation, be both acts of devotion and worship. And that, Father, may it be of compassion, justice, so that Christ's abundant sufferings will become the world's abundant correlation and also consolations, that we may also experience anew the salvation of our Lord. We make our prayers in the name of God the Father, amen, and of the Son, amen, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So light in our darkness, we beseech you, O God, by your great mercy, defend us from all dangers and perils of this night, for the honor and glory of your Son, our mediator, Jesus Christ. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Unto God's gracious mercy and protection, we commit you, your families, and your loved ones. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Peace in your hearts. Peace in your homes. Peace wherever you go. Peace when you go out, and peace when you come in. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you all this day and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Well with you this day and forevermore. Amen. Amen.